A desperate search is underway in the middle of the Pacific Ocean tonight after an Australian man fell from a cruise ship. The Quantum of the Seas had sailed from Brisbane to Tahiti and was on its way to Hawaii when the man fell from the 15th deck, setting off a major emergency operation.
A race against time on the ocean in the depths of night. Urgency over the loudspeaker.
Ladies and gentlemen, all guests and crew, we kindly ask to return to your stateroom and account for everybody that should be in your room. Should you be missing anybody, please call 911.
But I thought it was a drill because throughout the day, Royal Caribbean is drilling all the time, so I just thought it was nothing.
But this was the real thing. Headed for Hawaii and 15 days into the voyage, the Quantum of the Seas came to a stop as boats were deployed for a man overboard.
They were very, very prepared for this and they moved very, very quickly.
After two frantic hours, the ship resumed course. The search handed over to the US Coast Guard and Navy.
Okay, stop. That's enough. Stop, stop.
Guest had been alerted to two separate tragedies, possibly linked to one another. The first, a fatal medical episode.
90 minutes later, the call came out that someone had gone overboard and it turned out to be the partner of the person that passed away earlier.
The ship is very safe, so that's why it's very weird, the sense of, oh, is a man overboard. But there are terrible rumours on board, which is unsettling.
In terms of an incident where someone goes overboard, it would be extremely difficult for someone to fall overboard by accident.
10 News first contacted Royal Caribbean Cruises, which wouldn't comment further on the incident, but experts say the company would have followed every safety protocol.
Well, the cruise company will reevaluate their safety protocols around this, but to be quite honest with you, I don't think there is much more that they can do to avoid this happening.
While the ship is due to arrive in Honolulu in 2 days' time, tonight back home, there are two heartbroken families. Ha Nguyen for 10 News First.